30 years ago, we discovered man-made chemicals had punched a hole in the ozone layer. Is that hole here to stay? Waiting around to kill us? Today, we're trying hard to find out. Morgan Sandercock is about to test an experimental plane perfect for sampling ozone.
We think we can go as high as 90,000 feet.
Jim, you ready to go?
We're ready.
That's the big boy territory. That's where things can go wrong very, very quickly. If we lose cabin pressure, then the pilots could very easily pass out. And we don't have any automatic systems to recover from that.
Getting ready to roll.
Now, a glider might sound like a dangerous choice so high up, but gliders don't have engines, which means they can't pollute the team's samples.
Confirm tail dolly off.
Tail dolly is off. Wing wheel is off.
We are rolling at 11:32.
11:32. Written down GPS 5.
Airborne.
The Perlan glider uses air rising over the southern Andes to reach extraordinary heights.
Airspeed, 70 knots.
Looking beautiful.
And very high.
Traffic.
Yeah.
Feet up makes this the highest glider flight ever. But you've got to get this high to get a great picture of the ozone layer. The good news is that thanks to a global ban on ozone-harming chemicals, it looks like the hole is healing up. Our shield is regenerating.